Now we'll take a look at some examples of subtracting polynomials. Notice in our first example we're subtracting monomials. So in this type of problem, the most important step is identifying the like terms. Notice how here we have 2x terms, and here we have 2y terms. So we'll combine the like terms by adding or subtracting their coefficients, or the numbers in front of the variable factors. So for 2x minus 9x, since 2 minus 9 is negative 7, this would be negative 7x. And then for this minus 5y, we could write this as plus negative 5y. So we'll think of this as negative 5y minus 7y. And since negative 5 minus 7 is negative 12, we'll have negative 12y, which we can write as minus 12y. Now for the rest of these examples, we'll clear the parentheses and then approach them in the same way we did this first example. So to clear the parentheses here, remember we can think of putting a 1 here and distributing a 1. That won't change the sign of anything. We would have negative 12x plus 1. But notice how here we're subtracting this entire binomial. So if we put a 1 here, we would have to distribute a negative 1, and therefore it would change the sign of both terms. So we'd have minus 1x, and then we'd have a negative 1 times a negative 5, which is positive 5, so we have plus 5. And now we'll combine the terms like we did on the first example. Here we have 2x terms, and here we have two constants. So for negative 12x minus 1x, that's negative 12 minus 1 is negative 13. We'll have negative 13x. And then here we have a positive 1 plus 5, which is 6, so we have plus 6. We'll approach the next two in the same way. Put a 1 here, distribute a positive 1. That's not going to change the sign of anything. But here, since we're subtracting this entire binomial, if we put a 1 in here, we'd have to distribute a negative 1. So negative 1 times positive 3y to the fourth would be negative 3y to the fourth, which we can write as minus 3y to the fourth. Then here we have a negative 1 times a negative 3y cubed. That would be plus y cubed if we want 1y cubed. And now we'll identify like terms. We have 2y cubed terms here and here. And we have 2y to the fourth terms here and here. Let's start with the higher degree terms first. So for negative 4y to the fourth minus 3y to the fourth, since negative 4 minus 3 is negative 7, we would have negative 7y to the fourth. And then we have 15y cubed plus 1y cubed. Since 15 plus 1 is 16, we have 16y cubed. In our last example, put a 1 here, we'd have 8a squared minus 5a plus 7. And again here, we're subtracting this entire trinomial. So if we put a 1 here, because we're subtracting, we would distribute a negative 1 and therefore change the sign of every term. So we'd have minus 1a squared minus 9a and plus 1. Again, notice how the sign of each term here has changed. And now identifying our like terms, we have 2a squared terms, we have 2a terms, and we also have two constants. Looking at the a squared terms, we have 8a squared minus 1a squared. Since 8 minus 1 is 7, we have 7a squared. For the a terms, we have negative 5a minus 9a. Since negative 5 minus 9 is negative 14, we have minus 14a. And then we have 7 plus 1, which is 8, so we have plus 8. We'll take a look at a couple more examples in the next video. I hope you found this helpful.